want me to know?
I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, what can I say? Welcome to our array of fine pipers and drummers and fanfare. And thank you very much for coming out tonight in this wonderful Argyll weather. I do know that some people set out and have gone home again, and some people could be lost in puddles that are big enough to sink many a nation. Can I particularly welcome all our friends and supporters? I know that piping across Argyll and Bute wouldn't happen without the communities and the people that sit behind them, and nor would it happen without the sponsors. And in particular, I would like to welcome and thank Creative Scotland, and in particular the Scottish Government's Youth Music Initiative. And I would like to also thank the Argyll Piping Trust, several of whom have made the journey to be with us tonight. So as you can see on the stage and on the floor, we have 160-ish youngsters who all arrived here today at 3 o'clock. We've managed to extend the stage a wee bit, and it's had to be a wee bit elastic, as you can see it reaches out the side, but we're just delighted to have all of them and their fabulous tutors. Piping and drumming in Argyll and Bute is flourishing in both the schools, and I've said it's flourishing in the communities too. We've got bands going from novice to juvenile, and even now we've got our grade one band in amongst us as well. We've got soloists and service gold medals, we've got Glenfiddich medals, and we've got World Venue medals as well. It's a real honour to have this collection of young people here and their tutors with them, both community tutors and school tutors. A few pieces of housekeeping information. The toilets are over here. And during the interval, you'll find we'll have water and some sweeties over there, which if you need a bottle of water, please go and help yourself and get a wee donation in the basket. If the fire alarm goes out, unfortunately it is a fire, we've already had experience of this tonight, and if you see any of us looking a wee bit drookit, that's because we were out there waiting on the fire engine. So if the fire alarm goes out, we're out these doors, turn right and up to the bike sheds, which is an interesting thought. The other things, please turn off your phones. Don't just silence your phones, turn off your phones, because the phones, if you're getting a text in, they actually interfere with the recording. We're filming and recording the concert tonight, so it'd be great if you'd actually turn your phones off. You'll have been given a wee box. This is for your health and well-being. In no way does it reflect on the quality of the music you're going to hear tonight, but our youngsters, a lot of them are wearing ear protectors, and some of you should as well. It's your choice, but please make use of them if you feel you need to. After the first number, I'm absolutely delighted that I'm going to hand you over to Donald MC McPhee, who is going to lead us through the evening. Donald used to be known as McPhee, but he's now MC McPhee, and that's the way he's going to be for the rest of the time of his time with us, we think. So behind us and around us, we have our musicians. I'd like to give them a welcome, people, and then we'll have the dawning of the day. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Donald McPhee, and I come from another country, but I've been residing here in Scotland for the past 18 years. I teach for Argyll and Bute Council at Hermitage Academy in Helensborough, and I'm going to be your MC for this evening. So, what a great sight that was. Not only a great sight, the great sounds there. 160 pipers from the best that Argyll and Bute has to offer. A very, very dynamic system. We have kids that learn and then they grow and then they move on. In the back of your program, you'll find a number of distinguished people that have been a part of the Argyll and Bute piping program that have gone on to outstanding achievements. And I'm not going to be the kind of MC that just reads off what's in the program. I'll leave you to read what's in there. So is the young man ready yet? No. Outstanding. Here he is. This is a young man who's a student of Craig Campbell's. He's a third year student at Dunoon Grammar School. He'll be playing a march to Spain reel. His march is Neil Campbell BEM, which was composed by Ewan and Ian Campbell. I believe that Neil Campbell is this young man's grandfather. And afterwards, he'll be playing Susan McLeod and Major Manson. If you could welcome Jamie Campbell, please. Very well done, Jimmy. An outstanding march to spring and reel. Wow, what a future that young man has. Great job there, Greg. Next and on the agenda tonight is the prize-winning, the winning quartet from the Scottish Schools Pipe Band Championships of 2014. This is a new championship that's held during the springtime and is held at Broughton High School, and I'm probably saying that incorrectly, in Edinburgh. Broughton High School. So again, the me being from another land might have something to do with my pronunciation there, so my apologies. Anyway, this group went from Mull, and they went there on the day and walked away with the winning quartet prize. Callum McLean teaches in Mull, and the tunes that they'll be playing this evening is Walter Douglas, Terribus, Coral, and Duncan McGuinness, which is a collection of 2-4 marches that is played for the novice juvenile Gideon. You see movement. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the quartet winning performance from the Scottish Schools Pipe Band Championships of 2014. October Moore High School.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, John. Well done, boys. The next group that's going to be playing for you is from Dunoon Grammar School, and they are being taught by Annie Grant and Greg Wilson. Greg Wilson's a young man that's a member of the Inverary and District Pipe Band, the Grade 1 winning band. And Annie Grant is a former teacher of mine who took me through my exams at the RSPBA when I decided I wanted to become an adjudicator. I had to sit all these exams and take all these classes, and I had the privilege of being taken through those classes by Annie Grant. And here she is with her group, and they're going to be playing Dream Angus and Liberton Pipe Band. The next group from the Dunoon Grammar School is going to be to the competing band, and that's being led by Greg Wilson, who's a piper in the Inverary and District Pipe Band. And here comes the drums. I was going to tell you a wee story about Scotland and rain, but that's going to have to wait. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd welcome the competing band of the Dunoon Grammar School Pipe Band. Thank you. Thank you very much. The Newton Grammar School competing playing the first set. It's Terribus, the Piper's Cave, Minimer Dial, and Canvas for Lord Redcastle, followed by the second set, which was me, Michael's March, and Lochinside, and then finishing the 2-6-8 marches, Dr. McLean of Lewis and Pope Sergeant John Barkley. The next group that's going to be coming up, performing for you, is the homegrown group from the Lochgilphead High Ensemble, the majority of which of this group plays with the Mid Argyll Pipe Band. They are taught, of course, by the world-renowned and tremendously great guy and piper, Stuart Little, and they'll be playing for you The Haunting, which is a slow march, a slow air, written by Neil Dickey, and then followed by a jig called Glasgow Police Pipers by Donald MacLeod. Stuart gets younger looking by the day, eh? Well done, young man. Outstanding. That's what it's all about. When you can teach them to take themselves on and do that, that's what it's all about. That's what chokes me up, man. That's tremendous. Pardon me. The next young man, you heard him here earlier. He did the solo during the dawning of the day. His name is Josh Coates. He goes to this school. He's a local lad. He plays with the Lomond and Clyde Pipe Band and a student of Stuart Little's. He's raring ready to go. Here you go, Josh. It's all yours, man. Thank you, Josh. That was a hornpipe and jig of the Mason's apron. And in the nowadays culture of teaching children to pass exams versus teaching children to be creative and to do their own thing, that's a tune in which you're given and you go and you do with what you're with. And to have the confidence to come in and play like that in front of his own crowd is absolutely tremendous and great. The next group that's going to be performing is going to be the Kintyre School's Novice and Juvenile Bands. They are led by Ian McCarroll. Peter Ferguson helps out, Tommy Blue helps out with the bass and the tenor, and the drums is Callum Anderson. They have taken back to Campbellton no more than on four occasions the World Pipe Band Championships in either the novice juvenile or the juvenile category. I remember coming over as a young man with the St. Thomas Episcopal Pipe Band, my brother-in-law leading that program. And that was a juvenile band, and I was turned on by Ian's work and what a great job that he's been doing for the past 20-odd years. Absolutely fantastic, and what a great guy as well. Imagine working with one of the Beatles, eh? When you were in your youth, and being able to play on that famous recording of the Mullican Tire. He was awarded the Balvenie Medal at the 2013 Glenfiddich for his services to piping, and that's a tremendous honor that's bestowed upon somebody who has devoted a great deal of his life in the services to piping. And the amount of pipers and drummers and the collection of musicians that's here on the stage, absolutely fantastic. A real credit to the community of Campbellton, Ian, Peter, Tommy, and Campbell. So, without further ado, the Kintyre School's Novice and Juvenile Pipe Bands.
Thank you.
what a lovely polished sound and musical performance there. Absolutely outstanding. Well done, ladies and gentlemen. A real credit to Ian, to Peter, and to all of them. There's no doubt about that. We are going to be having a short break here, and then the second half will be commencing soon. I believe Catherine mentioned there's waters in the back, and water in the back, pardon me, some sandwiches, and if you'd like to make a donation whenever you take, whatever you take, that would be greatly appreciated. The one thing that I've definitely seen as far as the first half of the performance is what a direct reflection of the communities that's shown here and the direct community ownership that's involved in the band. If you take a look at each individual that's passing you by right now, you're looking at not only 500 to 1,000 pounds worth of instruments, but also kilts and uniforms and sporrans and hose and flashes and everything that's involved there. And it's a great deal in order to get that together. And that's what I love about my job, is that you're teaching the youth about their culture, and they form a sense of real community amongst the pipe band community, amongst themselves. They go out and they represent you on the BBC. They represent you when they go out at the various pipe band championships, and with great success that they've had as well. So we'll be commencing the second half of the show in roughly about 10 minutes. Thank you very much. Thank you. From the practice chanter and the drum pad all the way up into the Great Highland Bagpipe and the snare drum. When you start off and you want to learn the bagpipes, you start off on a practice chanter. And from there, you learn the correct fingering and the rudiments and the technique. And when you're ready to graduate onto the bagpipes, the intermediary instrument is called the goose. And that teaches you not to blow and to squeeze at the same time. A really, really important principle in playing the bagpipe. And one great thing about what you'll find out this evening, ladies and gentlemen, is that the coordination that's involved in order to play these musical instruments, as well as you can say any musical instruments, but tonight we're highlighting the Scottish side of things. And it's really tremendous. A tremendous sense of achievement that these kids go, and then they go into playing the scale cleanly, and then after the scale, their first tune, and then after their first tune, their fourth tune, and when they're after their fourth tune, then they go under the goose, and they can blow and squeeze, and then they go under the Great Highland Bagpipe. So this next performance is going to show you the rise from practice tutor onto the goose, onto the practice pad, and then to the pipes and to the drums. And this ensemble is the Kintyre Schools. It's an ensemble of players, and the introductory tune is going to be I See More. So without further ado, Stuart led this. There we go. The man here. Now, if I can just take a little bit of your time. I came over and started competing in Scotland about 25 years ago. And I was an outsider. I was an American with Highland and Ireland grandparents. And this young man that you're seeing his backside right now, he came up to me and he welcomed me, and he said to me, "Hey, listen, if there's anything I can do while you're over here, if you need any help, you need a place to stay, you need a ride to the games, whatever you're needing, don't be afraid to ask." And that was 25 years ago, and he's just the same gem of a guy now as he was back then. The work that he has done with the piping in this area is, man, there's not words to describe it. Bob Worrell announced it as meteoric at the Glenfiddich Championships this year, and What he has given to these children is absolutely tremendous, and he's a great role model in order for these kids to grow up and to look up to and to be like. In the States, everybody wants to be like Mike, be like Michael Jordan. I think in Scotland, we want to be like Stuart Little and Angus McCall. So Stuart, without further ado, please.
Thank you.
set there was a competition that started off with a Glasgow from Hamburg and finished with Dancing Feet. The tune before that was The Hills of Argyll. The tune that was played with the goose was The Bluebells of Scotland, and the tune before that was I See More. The next group that's going to be playing for you is a quartet led by Craig Campbell that includes Jamie Campbell, Rebecca Patterson, Campbell Walker, and Craig Campbell. They are from the Dunoon Grammar School, and this is the Dunoon Grammar School Quartet. That was a collection of reels, the first set, Fair Maid Milk, and the Brougham, Into the Harbour, Swallow's Tale, and The Wise Maid. And Craig just said there that apologies about the last tune, it'd be about the third time you've heard it tonight, but it's a tune that the kids love playing. A collection of jigs next, Dr. Flora McCauley, Pipe Major Donnie McGregor, and the Glasgow City Police Pipers. Craig, whenever you're ready.
Thank you.
The next group that's going to be playing for you is the Open High School Pipe Band, led by Angus McCall. Angus McCall just won solo piping's biggest prize, the Glenfiddich, at the end of October, and did that for the fourth time. You can read as far as in the program his achievements and stuff, and I don't know what it is about these guys up in Upper Argyllshire, but man, the gems, they're great musicians, they're great guys, they're great players, and they're great teachers. And this band here is the current runner-up world champions. They got the unfortunate prize of second place, the worst prize that there is to get, but they won that contest no less than 5 years ago and brought a world championship back to Oban. So without further ado, the Oban High School Piping.
Thank you.
That was the open school pipe band, as I told you before. This is two of my students from Heritage, and just kind of breaking up the traditional Scottish side of things, and keeping you in the mood for, oh, Christmas music you'll be hearing the next, 7 weeks. So here you go with a medley of Christmas tunes. One big part of what we do at Hermitage is we have a Christmas concert every year. And the pipers take part in that by having 5 pages of tunes in order to learn and all that stuff. I spoke a little bit earlier about the young man was playing up here and not teaching students how to pass exams. This is very much something that you find yourself here. You'll see tonight in all the music that's been played for you, so far probably about 100 tunes, you haven't seen a sheet of music nor a music stand yet. Forces the students in order to memorize tunes, which is really, really beneficial and outside of life. Each and every one of these individuals, the students, work with other groups, and whenever they're going out and venturing into the bad world out there, and they go up to a job interview and say, well, have you ever worked with other people before? Yeah, I've been doing it since I was 9. I've been a part of the open bagpipe program, or the Inverary bagpipe program, and you get a real sense of working with others and working as part of a team. And very, very proud of that fact as far as the Argyll and Bute piping program. So anyway, here we go with a selection of Christmas tunes that hopefully that you'll enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's the next group that's going to be coming up here is the drum fanfare. And I forgot to mention the drumming instructor at the Open High School, Bobby Davey. Pardon me about that, Bobby. Sorry about that. He's got an integral part of the Open program there, in the Open High School program. So the collection of drummers this evening is going to come onto the platform here. He's going to play for you a drum fanfare. Just hang on a second. I forgot to mention Bobby Davey happens to be up here to my left and to your right, the drumming instructor at Open High School. I mentioned the drumming instructors earlier, and I didn't mention Bobby. Sorry about that earlier. Sorry about that, mate. Right, here it is, the drum fanfare. This evening. There's nothing better than coming out and playing for folk. So thanks for coming out on a Monday night. Thanks for coming here to support us and to support what we and the instructors of the Argyll and Bute Piping Program do and what the students try and do. They work very hard in order to come up and to play for you. They learn discipline, they learn respect. A quality that's really diminishing nowadays is as far as listening. People nowadays They tend to be listening to respond to something instead of listening to learn. And what music does, at least what the instructors try and do and trying to develop a critical ear in when we're teaching music. On behalf of myself, on behalf of the instructors, on behalf of Catherine Mulkey and her team, Argyll and Bute, I would like to say thank you very much for coming tonight and supporting this event. You won't be hearing from me anymore, so thanks. What I'd like to do, I would like to ask for a vote of thanks from Councillor Donald McMillan, if you would come up and address the crowd, please. Okay, Donald.
Tonight has really been a fanfare of wonderful traditional music. The sound of the pipes and drums never fails to get your feet tapping and your heart swelling with pride. It has been wonderful to celebrate Argyll and Bute, young pipers and drummers. We have many talented young musicians in the community, and this is very encouraging. The future of traditional piping and drumming is safely in their hands. I'm sure like me, you have all enjoyed tonight's fantastic performance. You're all a credit to Argyll and Bute, and we're very proud of you. We would not have been able to enjoy tonight's concert without the support of Creative Scotland Youth Music Initiative, Argyll Piping Trust, and Argyll and Bute Council. Thanks are due to each of these organisations for their invaluable assistance and for helping to make tonight possible. Thank you also to the pupils and staff of Lochgilphead Joint Campus, the production team who made all this possible, and the team that tonight was really a big team project between them all. We must also remember the music teachers and parents, instructors and volunteers who support our young musicians and pipe band, who play a very important part in their success. I would finally like to say a big thank you to Don McPhee, who professionally chaired this evening's meeting. And last but no means least, please join me and express our appreciation for Argyll and Bute young musicians themselves. You have amazing talent and have given us a splendid evening of entertainment. Thank you.